Hi. Now let's discuss about the bus bar or conductor. The one or the same. Conductor, as you all know, that conductor is an element which carries a current in the circuit. Okay. Now bus bar is nothing but it is a conductor. Again, it is a conductor. It is carrying an electric current to which many connections can be made or may be made. So I'll come to that point now. So before that, let's see, bus bars are made up of copper or aluminium bars. So bar is nothing but what? It is a bus is nothing but, as you all know about the bus, the word bus is, in general, if you take our bus, traveling system, a transportation bus, in that bus what happened? We fill a number of people in them, into that, and then we'll just make it to move, right? So same way here, bus is nothing but a number of currents will be flowing into that. So look at this picture to understand it. This is bus bar. Thickness has been more thickness over there. See, this is incoming line. In a substation, we will be having not only one incoming line, we may be having more than one incoming line in a substation. Means, if I take a substation, example our Alipur substation, there we get incoming line from the Guthi power plant, or we get incoming line from the even BTPS. So there are different types of connections, means we have different incoming lines. So one substation, one power plant will be giving a input to a substation, and maybe I'm getting a input from the another substation to the, so I have taken two example here, two power plants are generating electrical energy, and that is given to a substation. So the current flowing here will be different, and the current flowing here may be different, but voltage will be constant because we have a same transmission voltage over there, right? So that voltage level will be same. That is what we should understand. Bus bars will be operating at a constant voltage. Here it is, operates at a constant voltage. Okay. And it will be in the shape of a rectangular shape. Okay. So heavy, this is different current, this is different current. So when we add these two current, the more current will be there in the conductor. So the size of this should be greater so that it can withstand the heavy current over there. Okay, so that is why it is called a bus bar. And one current, and this is second current, so n number of currents are entering into this. So it is going to carry the more connections may be made, current to which many connections can be made. So bus bar is nothing but I have two incoming lines here, and I have shown only three outgoing lines. So this may be having different current, this may be having different current, this may be having a different current, right? So these are called conductors, whereas this is called a bus bar, because this is having the capacity of holding a more current, and it is distributing the current for n number of lines here. Okay, we have more number of connections to this bus bar. That is why it is made up of thick bars. Okay, it is a copper material or an aluminium material, but it is made up of a bar or rectangular shape, which is going to have more thickness so that it can withstand the high current. Okay, so that is why it is named as a bus bar. A simple conductor is nothing but what? It is going to carry the current through that small current. If you have a greater current, then the area of the conductor should be increased. When we increase that area, so that the current will be more. When current is more, it can be connected with the more number of lines. That is a concept. That is bus bar. We use this bus bar in a substation. Okay, all incoming lines and outgoing lines are connected to the bus bars. Next we talk about the insulator. Insulator is just providing a support to the conductor, means all bus bars, all these will be placed on an insulator so that it should not be coming in contact with the earth. So there will be a there will be a separation. This conductor will be placed on an insulator, and that insulator will be placed on a pole, and then that will be given to a connected placed on earth. So there should be no connection between the ground and this conductor, any bus or a conductor. So we separate it by using an insulator. Okay, so that insulator is just separating or supporting the conductor, and it is confine the current to the conductor. It will just make sure that the current is just flowing in the conductor, not in any other supporting parts. If current should not flow in a supporting pole, or it should not flow in a flow through a ground, right? So that will be taken care by the insulator, and generally it is made up of porcelain. This is about the insulator which we use in a substation.